We've all been there. One day you open the File Explorer and you see that you don't have nearly as much free storage space as you thought. You might have an idea of what the culprits might be, but there could be others that you never thought of. So in this video, I'm going to be going over, in no particular order, 5 unexpected causes of a full hard drive or SSD. And you'll see some pro tips on finding exactly what the problem is as well. Before we jump in, I want to give a big thanks to today's sponsor, Guardio. Guardio is a browser extension that provides real-time protection from all sorts of threats while browsing the web. For example, it blocks malicious sites using more than just blacklists, but also in-house developed methods for detecting phishing and malware sites and more. And that's all before threats even have a chance to do any harm. It also scans your other browser extensions and alerts you if there are any disguised malicious extensions installed. And for websites that generate shady notifications after tricking you into enabling them, Guardio will trace the actual source of these notifications and eliminate them. Plus, there are other features such as information leak monitoring, which, like I've mentioned in the past, happens way more than you think, and search hijack correction if any sites attempt to change your browser settings without your permission. You can scan your browser for threats for free by visiting guardio.theojo, that's guard.io/theojo, and installing the extension, and you'll also get a 7-day free trial to premium features such as real-time threat removal. So if you want a clean and secure browsing experience, again, visit guard.io/theojo, link in the description, and check out their affordable premium plan for full protection. And with all that being said, let's continue. Now, before I get into the top causes, let me quickly show you how to easily figure out what the cause is for your computer specifically, so you can actually make use of the list. And the best way, in my opinion, is to use a free program called WinDirStat. I've mentioned it before, and it basically scans your hard drive or SSD and visually maps out where all the files are by size and location. So at a quick glance, you can see what's taking up the most space. Later, I'll also go over some additional tips, at least in Windows, for how to maximize your storage space. Okay, so let's get into those top 5 reasons. And the first one we have is one you might not have thought of, which is the Windows index file. This is what Windows uses when you go to search for a file, and it basically stores a bunch of info about files and folders on your computer. Depending on how many files you have and what indexing settings you use, this thing can be huge. With me, for example, at one point I did a scan and it was taking up over 100 gigabytes. Now, in my case, I had basically enabled Windows to index every file on my computer, which is not the default, so yours probably isn't that big. But still, it might be bigger than you think. You can find the index file at this path, and it's just called windows.edb. If you do think your Windows index is too big, you can search for indexing options in the start menu, and if you hit modify, you can uncheck directories so they won't be indexed. So if you have certain drives or folders that you know contain a ton of files, but you won't ever need to search through them, then you can just disable them there. Next up, we have a multi-parter because I'll have some extra specific examples for it. But the main point is the app data folders for programs. If you've seen my video explaining the app data folders, you know that this is basically where programs will store files for a particular user, or the program itself may be installed there. And these usually are not temporary files either. So the unexpected thing is that even if you download and install a program, even if the program itself isn't that big, it might create huge files over time. So it's one to be aware of, and when looking at the directory sizes, it's likely to be one that stands out. Now, a specific example I want to point out is one almost no one knows about, which is the file system directory in Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, or any other Chromium-based browser. This is located in your app data local folder, and then for Google Chrome, it's under google/chrome/userdata/default/filesystem. For Edge, instead of google/chrome, it's Microsoft/Edge. You see, all of these browsers have a dedicated folder that allows web services to store files there. These might be used for web apps, or your browser may actually be using it as a download location for all files, not your actual downloads folder. Sometimes the browser will treat it like a temporary directory and delete some of the stuff after it closes, or not. And some old web apps you use might have stored stuff in there that you don't even know about. All right, on to the next one. We have the temp folder in the app data local directory. I'm considering this one separate to the last because this folder is a shared location where most programs are going to put their temporary files, and plenty of these files might stick around a while. That's not necessarily bad because programs need to make temporary files, but it becomes a problem when you have a bunch of space being taken up by programs you barely use or never use, but their files are still there. Now, that being said, don't just go and delete everything in there. Apparently, some programs may store important stuff in there, surprisingly. What I do is just look to see if there are any particularly massive folders in there, and then look in it to see what it is, and decide if I want it. There are some in mine that are relatively large, but it looks like they're for Visual Studio, for example, which I do want to keep, so it doesn't mean you have to delete it just because it's taking up space. And as always, follow the general rule that if you don't know what it does, don't delete it. Now let's talk about the recycle bin, and not for the reason you think. I mean, yes, the recycle bin may indeed be a huge storage hog if you've never cleared it out. If you want to see how much space is taking up total, the easiest way is probably to search for the disk cleanup tool built into Windows and just scan the main drive C and it will show the size. Or if you're using WinDirstat, it will show it in the root directory of the drive. But the main reason I want to bring up the recycle bin is a misunderstood feature I see people talking about that even I was wrong about. If you right-click and go to Properties for the Recycle Bin, you'll see an option that says Custom Size and Maximum Size in megabytes. And like literally everyone else, you probably assumed that that means that would be the maximum size of the Recycle Bin total before it starts deleting old stuff. But no. What that feature actually sets is the maximum file size of any given single file you delete, and whether it should go into the Recycle Bin at all. If you've ever seen that warning that this file is too big for the recycle bin, that's what this setting is for. I know, it's really dumb, it should be more specific. So what I did is set the max size here to 6 gigabytes, but you can set it to whatever you want, so that nothing going into the recycle bin would be too massive. And you can still always go in there and just sort by size and just delete the biggest stuff so you can keep the smaller files way longer just in case. Just keep in mind that the recycle bin folder is actually a combination of the recycle bins from all your drives. So make sure you enable the original location column to see which drive a file was on if you're trying to free up space on one specifically. And finally, we have one that is actually pretty expected, but I figured I'd still mention it because it sneaks up on you, which are games. I know, it's no secret that games are huge these days, but if you're like me, if you beat a game, you don't think to uninstall it immediately after, and you end up forgetting about it. That's again where something like WinDirstat comes in handy, because huge directories become immediately obvious, and you might not have remembered otherwise. For me, I forgot I had installed Cyberpunk on this drive, so that huge block became really obvious. But single huge files aren't always the biggest culprit. A lot of times, it's a ton of medium-sized files that really add up. So let me go over some of the other best places to clear out some space. One is the downloads folder, which I personally treat pretty much as my own personal temporary files folder. What I usually do to clear out space in here is just sort by the largest files and go through and delete anything that's more than 100 megabytes or so. Another advanced tip is to take advantage of symlinks. If you haven't seen my video about symbolic links in Windows, check it out. They're basically like super shortcuts that make a file actually look like it's in another location, not just a shortcut. This can be useful if a program doesn't give you the option for where to install it, or at least some of its large components. You can just move the files to a different drive and then create a symlink to that folder so it will still work and not take up any space on the first drive. And the final tip is most cloud storage services these days offer some kind of option to keep your files in the cloud, but only show a virtual version on your drive until you go to open it. So if you have some files that you rarely use and don't mind waiting to be downloaded, that could be an option. So I think that pretty much covers it. Now you should at least know how to easily figure out where all your storage has gone. Thanks again to Guardio for sponsoring this video. Be sure to visit Guardio, that's guard.io/theojo, to install the extension and scan your browser for threats for free. And that link is also in the description. If you want to keep watching, the next video you should check out is the one where I was talking about that app data folder and what those are all even about. I'll put that link right here. And if you want to subscribe, also be sure to click the bell for notifications. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.